Hello and welcome to Position 6, the podcast in which I, Daniel Offord, aka Mr. Big Jams, get to know some of the most important and exciting people in Dota 2. This week's episode is of Notail, who will be best known to some of you as the last winner of the International with OG and the winner of several majors with the team. He started his career with Fnatic in Dota, attending several Internationals with the team and sticking together with the same lineup for a long time. He later left the team to join Team Secret and then Cloud9, and then from that team formed Monkey Business, which became OG, with whom he's had massive success. Okay, so we're just a couple of weeks away from the Epicenter Major. Talk me through where you feel OG are as a team at the moment.
I would say we're in a pretty comfortable place overall. We kind of have been feeling very good ever since TI, about many things, right? I think TI was a great accomplishment for all of us individually. We did have a rough beginning to our season with our roster breaking apart, Ana taking a break. And we were having a bit of a difficult time making the right fit. Now with Ana being back, things feel very natural. Things have been going pretty well. Dota is at an all-time high when it comes to this competition. But we're feeling good. We're feeling very good overall.
And getting Ana back immediately, your results improved as soon as he joined the team again. Is the answer to that simply that Ana is a better player than the replacements you had, or does he just fit the OG way slightly better?
So the thing about like a player leaving and a player joining, Ana is one of the most incredible Dota players I've ever seen. Can't take anything away from him in that regard, but sometimes it just doesn't work with what you have. Like, the teammates have to work together. The playstyles, their ideas about the game, a lot of small things just come together when trying to make a team. It's a big puzzle that you try to make when forming a team with certain personalities and playstyles.
So is there a sense that OG is quite a difficult team to fit into? Because not every team has the difficulty that you've had replacing and changing players. Is there something very special about Ana that works very well with OG's playstyle?
As for fitting into OG, it's a bit hard for me to say because I was there since the very beginning. This question is maybe better asked to Ana or probably best up, yes, but I imagine coming from the outside, it can be very overwhelming at first, getting into this and trying to get on this very high level Dota. I've just heard a bit from other players and stuff, like also when I know the feeling myself, when you lose to a team like Liquid, and when their Liquid's playing really well, it just feels like you got slapped in the face. And it's because some of these games are really, really fast, really high paced. And it's almost like a different game from what you've ever played before. And that can be quite, like, it can rock your feet a bit. But I like to think that we have a good environment and that players quickly are allowed to settle in and speak their mind. This is anyways what we strive for.
Do you feel that the current lineup of OG is the best it's ever been?
I definitely have to say that this is the most functioning team I've ever been in terms of many things. It, of course, is a long season and we had a really good beginning when we formed the team. We had an incredible run at TI. It was very incredible, some of the best Dota games of my life. So that's something I hold very dear. It's hard for me to say that this is not the best Dota lineup I've ever played on. But there's an element of sacrifice, an element of real crazy material that just, it's not something you'd normally look for when you're trying to make a pro team. But these things, like when they then show in the games, to me, it's magic, some of the games that we have. So, yeah, it's my all-time favorite team.
So you obviously tried to replace that magic with ILTW and Prycat. Is there an alchemy in trying to do that? Or did you just find it impossible to find the right mentality to fit into that magic?
I definitely think that Ana has a better fit directly, like talking about a magnet, having a North and a South Pole. We have some people in the team who are very vocal. Me, Sebastian, Yese, we've talked a lot throughout the years in the past, and these are things that we like to talk about and pass on. And often it also means that we have more things to say in the games. Ana is a person who's more comfortable also when he's not needed to say much, when he's not needed to talk on the communication side. So in this sense, I think it fits really well. Whereas as soon as you throw in maybe another carry player, and I definitely think PyCat and Igor, they had some really good things to say about the game. It wasn't like already here. We're not making like the North South Pole on a magnet kind of thing happen where it just balances out. That could be one example. I mean, with those two players, they're incredible in their own regard. It's like, it's all about making making people work together, making a team work. And sometimes it's just not, it's a good fit, but maybe not good enough. Dota is cutthroat, you know. Dota is a hard game.
And looking back to TI, you mentioned it earlier. Everyone was obviously very surprised by you winning the international. Were you as surprised as everybody else, or did it come not as a shock?
I think it all depends on when you would ask me that question. If you would have asked me the question very early on, before the roster had been made, just when the roster split, I would have probably said no. There's no way. Would have probably not been super feasible. But as soon as we started playing together, and as soon as we had our boot camp in Berlin and we qualified to TI through the Open, I would have probably said that the chances are better than ever. So yeah, like not watch out for sure getting number one, but top three was I could see it. I could definitely start seeing it.
Do you feel a certain pressure to prove yourself one last time for the international? Because you've had a reasonable season, you did quite well in the last major, but you've not had a big explosive result that's really set your flagpole. Is that important to you going to the international? Do you just go in with it a blank slate, as it were?
So I definitely don't believe winning is going to make it easier for us. That puts us more in the spotlight. That makes people look at us more. I always think that less people looking at you being the underdog is a fa it's a more favorable thing to have going. But why not take the challenge? You know, if we win, and we also win TI, easy. It's like we're not just gonna break the curse again in a way. Like we're gonna break all the curses. We're gonna go to China. We're gonna win two TIs. That's the plan.
Okay.
We're gonna make it happen.
I look forward to it.